Chinese, I think, are very deeply conflicted about the North Korea issue. And we've seen that played out since March 26th, the sinking of the Chonan, where the initial Chinese reaction to the sinking of that ship by North Korea was silence, followed by an encounter between Hu Jintao and the South Korean president in Shanghai, in which the Chinese, several weeks after the event, finally conveyed their condolences, followed shortly thereafter by a visit by Kim Jong-il to China. The Chinese, I think, are trying to play both sides of this game. I don't think they've given up on their fundamental goal on the peninsula, which is to maintain stability. And they are grudgingly willing to accommodate lots of excesses by the North Koreans. And the most recent example of that is what happened on March 26th. The Chinese have still not signed on or supported or agreed to the findings of the international panel, investigative panel, that concluded that this was an attack by North Korea. But a number of Chinese and a number of Chinese newspapers have come out in fairly stark and strident terms to criticize North Korea, to criticize North Korean actions, both in terms of its nuclear developments and other developments. So the bottom line, I think, for the Chinese is this notion of being very conflicted. Last year, I understand, there was a fairly senior-level Chinese meeting at the end of the summer to discuss China's policy towards North Korea, in which there was reportedly a very lively debate. Now, the debate came out, the result of the debate was that the Chinese decided to stay the course, continue to support North Korea, continue to perhaps look the other way in response to some of its excesses. But the fact that there was a debate was rather interesting. The fact that there was a faction or a group in the Chinese leadership that argued for a major change in Chinese policy towards North Korea, I think, is significant. There are several newspapers, including a couple affiliated with the Communist Party, that have run editorials and op-ed articles that have been bitterly critical of North Korea. A number of Chinese scholars with close connections to the leadership have written about North Korea, including saying things that North Korea is a security liability to the People's Republic of China. That's a remarkable term when you think about it, and something that the Chinese would never have said 5 or 10 or 15 years ago, but they're saying it now. But the bottom line is still that despite the fact that there are different views in China, the arc of Chinese policy towards North Korea is still the preservation of stability more than anything else. And I think that is something that we're going to have to contend with. But the fact that there is a dissenting view in Beijing, the fact that there is another group of people who are willing to look at this issue a bit differently, I think gives us some hope that perhaps we can continue to attack this issue with the Chinese and get them to move another few steps in a more positive and cooperative direction.